Hello everybody and welcome back to the railway. I didn't make any videos yesterday, and for once there's a good reason for that, because I've been doing some major upgrades up here. So first I've replaced the dodgy laptop with a decent computer for Railmaster, and I've noticed that using that means that I've got a much more responsive system now, and a lot of the issues have just been ironed out simply by the fact that we've got a proper computer. This is the one that was over there originally. I moved it over here because obviously I'm replacing my main one downstairs, and that's coming up here, and that's going to be going back over there. I've got a new monitor over there for it ready. That's not happening just yet, but anyway, so this one was spare, so the laptop was starting to die, so we struck while the iron was hot. There's also been some major track updates. They are full at the moment, but if I head over, you can see there that there's been some changes, and as you'll see, there are now three rails. I'm just joking, that's just a siding. It would be fun though, wouldn't it, but the scenery wouldn't allow it, and I can't fit a third rail behind the computer desk, and I think we'd have a few troubles. I've had troubles with this Lego, with this Duplo station as well, because, well, not station, tunnel thing. Because it's now needs to be a lot wider, so it's had to move forward. Anyway, Great Western Day. So as you've probably already seen, we've got 7 locos out on the layout from 5 different classes. Now all of these are Great Western locos. Some of them do say BR on them, for British Railways of course, but these locos all originated from the Great Western Railway, so you just have to excuse that. So we've got the 5 classes. We've got the 6-100 class, which is the tank over there. We've got the castle class, Hogwarts castle loco, which is strictly BR loco, but it originated from the Great Western. We've got the king class, as we saw the other day, King George VI is going to make another appearance. The county class, we've got County of Cornwall, again I think you've seen before. We've got 3 hall classes, which is Hagley Hall, Albert Hall, together there, double heading. And Lord Westwood, which officially is a hall class. And I, making use of this better computer, I managed to find the page about Lord Westwood. Let's get this sorted. And as you can see, it is a hall class. Hall class. And it was released in 1973 or 1974. And it was released for 2 years. Running number 25555. And there is some information. You can find that on hornbyguide.com. And I'm not using Railmaster today, but that's just on the screen because that's what normally be on the screen. Well, as you know, I haven't got any Great Western rolling stock as such. I've got one coach, I think. So most of the rolling stock isn't Great Western, but it's a loco video, so try to ignore that. And we'll get started now. We're going to run Lord Westwood first, along with the Hogwarts Castle class locomotive. So the 2 red ones are out first, and we've got to get Hogwarts out of the siding, and Lord Westwood's already on the main line. Okay, we're going to be running in strictly DC mode today. I've only got one of these locos which actually has a DCC chip inside, so there's no point converting the railway to DCC mode today. So it's all going to be done on the analog controller. The first, as you can see there, the Hogwarts Castle locomotive is ready to leave its siding, and it's going to be going on the inside route, and as soon as she's going, Lord Westwood will soon depart also. Now it's been a good while since this one's run, so we'll see how she does. Okay, here we go. And Lord Westwood's also going to make a move now as well. So, when you're ready, sound your imaginary whistle, and here we go. Obviously, Lord Westwood always gets favour because of his chuckling sounds. Now, let's watch those two go. Something's whistling. Okay, I think it's just about time to put these two lovely trains back to bed, and we'll start with the next two, but first I'll show you them going back to wherever I'm going to put them. Okay. And in comes Lord Westwood, straight past the county of Cornwall there. Hopefully we won't get too close, but we'll see what happens. Now she's backing in, so we're going to have to go as steady as possible. I think that's about right. Okay, now we're going to be getting King George out, as well as the Hall classes. So I'm going to test out some of the new point work, and to do that we've got to just pull him forwards just a tad, so that we can get the points open. So I'm going to throw these points open now, and we'll get him out. Okay, I think we're ready. Okay, that's as far as we need to go, and now we're going to reverse him back across the point work. There we go. I think we'll reset those points and we'll get the Hall classes out. So here they are, the two beautiful Hornby and Hornby Triang Hall class locomotives. Of course they've both had their own video together a few months back now, where they pulled separate trains. Of course now they're double heading, and they've got two junctions to go through a tunnel, and then they're on the main line. So without further ado, let's get them off. Or not. Dun dun dun. What's happening? Perhaps I need a nudge. Nothing. That's very unlikely. Oh, there we go. Well, nothing happened, and then I came over to fix them, and they suddenly worked. So, no questions asked. And here they are in full swing. Okay, so the express train's running well. Let's get King George VI to run as well, and we'll watch them all go round. So there's another three lovely locos, ready to go back to bed. It's fairly straightforward for both of these because I can go forwards in literally, so let's give, we'll go with these first. Let's move them off gently. Put them back where they live. There we go. Okay, now for King George, back she goes. So with this design, it's been specially made so that any train can come in and out from any direction. So in this case, we're gonna bring King George around here, up through these 1, 2, 3 sets of points, back round, and that eventually leads back to where he came from. Okay, we'll do that now.
All right.
And she's off. Heading back, so we'll see how successful this is. It might just be a big derailment, but we'll see. Okay, well that was a reasonable success, no major derailments, and I think we'll move straight on to the next subjects. Okay, there she is, the County of Cornwall, that's the next subject to appear, so we'll get her to come out now. So there you have it, the county class. She has to go at this sort of speed on DC because the voltage drops around the other side. So here's the Great Western 6100 locomotive. We're ready to go now, I think. So I'll go to the controls and she'll be off. There we go, and she's lovely as ever. Well, there you have it, guys. That's all 7 of them. Hope you enjoyed it today, the Great Western Day. I'm rhyming now. Well, I think it's time to go and get this lot edited. Filmed quite a lot today. Thank you very much, as always, for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. Have a nice weekend, guys. See you soon.